Hi, this is Rick Adams from practicalcsm.com, and you join me for episode 38 in our series entitled Customer Success, Rants and Musings. And episode 38 asks the question, what is a customer segment and why might I segment my customers? So that's our topic for today. And as always, we'll just have a very brief dive into it. So let's first of all define what we mean by a segment. Very straightforward. A segment, it's a section, a subgroup of the whole, like a segment of an orange. So when we segment, we're dividing our customers into sections or subgroups of the whole. And this has been done with customers for very many years. R&D, for example, or the product team will use customer segmentation when they're thinking about creating products. So they'll be looking for a segment of the market, a segment of our customers who have a particular need, and they're going to develop a product to meet the specific customer needs and requirements of that segment. And marketing teams also use customer segmentation all of the time and have done for many, many years, again, to create marketing messages aimed at just one segment's specific sort of emotions or feelings, or again, their needs or their values or whatever it is that they want to particularly focus down and attract that part or that subsection or that segment of the market with that particular marketing message. So that's the concept of segmentation as it has been used for very many years. Now, from a customer success perspective, we also can use customer segmentation in order to determine specific customer success service needs. And then having thought about, well, that group, they have these needs. This group, they're slightly different. They have these needs. And then perhaps this third group has these other needs. We can then think about how to fulfill those needs. So for example, we might end up with a high touch segment, a mid touch segment, and a low touch or tech touch segment, where we are spending more time with the bigger customers with more complex needs and requirements, and frankly, whose revenues and income streams enable us to provide a more feature-rich customer success service than we would be able to do perhaps for some of our customers who have lower budgets and have perhaps also less complex requirements and don't need so much of our time and don't need so much intervention. So there we go. That's the concept of our customer success usage of customer segmentation. And it should be based upon the customer journey. So when we're thinking about, well, how do we work out what the segments are, then we turn to the customer journey. So what we're looking at is the touch points. We're saying, okay, along the journey, the part that is post-sales, obviously, the customer success management is responsible for, you know, what are all the steps in the journey? What are the touch points? What are the emotions? What are the feelings? And how can we then divide up as for different journeys? So customers with the same journey would be in one segment, and customers with a significantly different journey would be in another segment. And we've got to decide, you know, what we mean by significant. Because what we don't want to end up with is, yeah, 32 or 232 for that matter, different segmentations. It's far too painful. What we want is a handful of segments. So 2, 3, 4, 5 segments, okay. But, you know, 25, no, it's too complicated for us to manage. So we want significant changes, not tiny changes. But at the same time, of course, where there is a significant change, then it should be considered and we should segment based upon that. So that's the decision you've got to make. Okay, so that was just a little bit about segmentation as it relates to customer success management. So really, as we said, we're using the customer journey to segment, and then we're determining the requirement for customer success services and building a customer success service for each segment to fulfill their needs in the best way possible. I hope you found that useful. So that's me, Rick Adams from practicalcsm.com, saying thank you for listening. And we'll be back with a new rant very soon. Please do subscribe to this channel. It helps us because it helps with the algorithms with YouTube. The more subscribers we have, the more YouTube promotes our videos. So please do hit the subscribe button. If not for yourself, then for me. Thank you.